down south, barbecue's a tradition. And down here, we take pride in how well we can cook a pig, how tender, how moist, how flavorful, how tasty, and we take a pride in our sauces. And if you want somebody to jump on you quick and to cheat on an Amtrak, you come down here and taste their stuff and tell them it sucks.
I am a self-made barbecue extraordinaire. On a flameless grill, just put it on, go in the house, watch the TV, wait for two commercials, go outside, flip it, and wait for like two more commercials, it's done.
I always cook over wood. I don't like mesquite. I like just regular old hickory wood or regular old pecan, and I cook over the embers. You know, for me to cook a 150-pound hog takes me about 8 to 10 hours.
And if you would like to know what's going to be on my barbecue menu for this summer, plain and simple, chicken. And if you don't know what we're having the second day, chicken.
Now, I can make this thing called chicken crack, which is probably what I'm second best known for. It's a barbecue chicken conglomeration that, Bo, I'm telling you, it's like crap. You eat a piece, you're coming back for 30 more.
Let's eat it while it's hot, boys and girls.
Atlanta, thank you, sir. How y'all fellas doing? You sit there and good, you shaking?
We also have passed down our sauce from generation to generation to generation.
You did good, Pop. You did real good. Pop,
this is off the chain again. We guard those recipes. You know, honestly, you got a better chance of winning the lottery without a ticket than getting a recipe to my pot of salt. The most special thing about being able to barbecue, and it's the one time besides a wedding where everybody is smiling, everybody is happy, and everybody's there.
Hey, look, I got to go. I ain't got time. Listen, I got to go grill.